This didn't just happen. This is a master of design. God put those there for chiropractors to get hold of. If you have a close look at a vertebra, you see that the two transverse processes and the spinous processes are placed in such a position and strong enough for a chiropractor to use as a lever, and by putting it back into place, health returns to the patient. I cannot think of anything more fantastic. And that just drove me forever.
Thousands and thousands of chiropractors around the world treating thousands and thousands of patients every year and getting the results and reproducing the results. There's something happening.
Who's this bloke you go to see? Because he'd come in some days like this and ask me if he could go to the chiropractor and come back like this.
And if people were really intellectual, they would open their eyes, look at it and say, there's something happening here. What is it?
We got thousands of sciatic cases or brachial neuritis or things like that. We take care on a daily basis and we think it's just normal business.
Innate is the good in man. Innate is the God in man. Innate cannot be tricked or deceived. And when you're in touch with innate, you're in touch with the infinite.
We don't rule the universe, we work with the universe.
Exactly.
We're in partnership with the universe. That's the most important thing of our life.
It's an enormous thing you set free when you get that nerve system to work properly again. All the wisdom of the universe, basically, is set free for that body to work properly.
Just with my hands, I've been able to set that segment back in place just as it was always intended to live, because Gonstead showed me how to do it. And this restores the life force in the patient.
We know that there's 100% perfection out here, meaning universal intelligence that's out there. The human body can't be 100% all the time. And our job is to try to open up the communication between the 100% up here and the cell at the cellular level.
Find where the problem is. Actually, find the problem. Find the subluxation. Find where the body's malfunctioning.
Chiropractic is finding the cause of the problem.
If you walk into the bathroom, the tap's running, the bath's overflowing, water all over the floor, massage and physiotherapists, they grab the mop because they look at the tight muscles and say, you've got tight muscles. That's as silly as a plumber coming in and saying, you've got water on the floor, we know that, but why? So we go back and turn the tap off. When we remove the nerve irritation, those things disappear. So we go back and look at the cause.
What made him such a great chiropractor was his comment about accept it where you find it. He went where it was and accepted that. And he just absolutely lived that philosophy out. And that's what made him so great.
When I come to the chiropractor, we're able to investigate this, find out what the problem is. And this is just so important that we develop with our expertise. Probably nothing in the body that has one purpose. They're all multifunctional.
The body is in harmony when every part of that body is working for the total good of every other part. So the body's more than the sum of its parts.
It's the intent to do the right thing in the healthcare system and to influence people's health in the right way that will keep them on track.
And we knew the body could heal from inside out. We knew that. They taught us that in the school. And we knew when, by the time we left there, if we could find the nerve that was causing the problem, and if we could fix it even partially, that the patient would get better, and that's what we saw in results. And as soon as you see a few like that, this drives you to get better, and that's what we did. We tried to get be the best we could as quickly as we could.
One chiropractic adjustment, and nobody else on earth can do that except a properly trained chiropractor.
When the adjustment was described by B.J. Palmer, in that when he said the adjustment is a concussion of forces, but what we have to do to make the adjustment really successful, we have to be able to get ourselves into a mode of concentration, and that force that comes out of our body, if it's totally concentrated, That's the part that really does a lot in the thrust. And you can't think about anything else.
Done your analysis? Yeah. You're satisfied that the vertebra is subluxated? Yes. You're satisfied the listing's a PRS? Yes. Okay. Right. Now relax and enjoy it.
He said, if you want to improve and find out more, he said, you look further into that subluxation. He said, don't go out there. He said, look in there. That's where the answers are. They're not out here. They're in there.
We have to first of all think that what I'm going to do for this patient with the adjustment today is the most important thing I'm going to do for that man today. No matter else what happens, that's the most important part of my life for him.
And we're talking about, you know, what is the power of one adjustment. Sometimes it's so profound, you can't believe it.
Approach healthcare from the conservative end first before you go to the radical end of care, which is the way it should have been from the start.
It has gone wrong from an inside job. People who have decided to take away from hands-on, you see, there's no machine ever built or ever will be that can follow what we said and our ability to recognize it. The machine can't recognize it, it's our hands.
I want to see the least invasive, the simplest type of care that won't mess up my life before I say, I'm going to throw a bunch of drugs or I'm going to have somebody cut parts out or rearrange parts of it.
My license says that I can treat a patient without the use of drugs or surgery. No side effects and no reason to hurt the patient. We can't use drugs or surgery. So we're way ahead of the game if we can help you without it.
Patients will speak out and say, I am not going to have this anymore. I'm not going to just take a drug and get more ill from the drug. It's education. And the more that we educate people, the better the world will be in lots of different areas, not just healthcare.
All it needs is the people who have the integrity, the regard for the patient, the willingness to do what's right, the willingness to get the right result for the patient, to keep generating public support. That's what chiropractic needs.
If we'd have stuck with Dee Dee's original premise of what those old boys wanted her to do, we would have taken over the healthcare world, I'm pretty sure.
Chiropractic is a universal truth. The body has an inborn ability to heal itself, and that applies to every human on the planet. So if there's enough of us that practice to the truth of chiropractic, it will still be one of the biggest healthcare professions in the world in 50 years.
Being clinically effective, being cost effective, with a lot of competent chiropractors on board and a lot of happy patients.
The Gonstead system of chiropractic is really well founded. It's explained in neurology, and it just is a joy to be a chiropractor when you're practicing the Gonstead system.
He said, Gonstead sat down with her as the last patient. He said, you know, I was fortunate enough to be given a gift. And the only way that gift is of any value is for me to pass it on to my patients.
No, it works, and I know the world needs it.
And those people that hold on to real chiropractic will be champions, and people will know that.
Well, the coolest thing about chiropractic is it changed people's lives.
We don't rule the universe, we work with the universe.
Exactly.
We're in partnership with the universe. That's the most important thing of our life. There's hardly anybody can make that statement, you know that?